Humanity likes nothing more than building insanely large and complicated structures, except perhaps watching videos about large and complicated structures built by other people. In today's video, well, obviously, we're going to do the latter. We're not going to be building any megastructures today. While ancient people had some amazing engineering achievements, we've all seen videos about the pyramids and the Great Wall and things like that. As such, today we wanted to focus on the amazing achievements of relatively modern engineering, such as... Number 10. The Three Gorges Dam. China's Three Gorges Dam is one of the most impressive engineering feats of our time, and one of the most controversial ones thanks to the project's environmental and human cost. When its construction began in 1994, it was the country's largest engineering project. Then, at the time it was completed in 2006, it was the world's largest dam structure. These days, though, it doesn't even crack the top 20 in terms of the dam's physical size. It's a massive concrete gravity structure that's 7,660 feet long and up to 607 feet tall. It contains 463,000 metric tons of steel and 37 million cubic yards of concrete. Despite being dwarfed by several other super dams, the Three Gorges Dam is still easily the most productive hydroelectric plant in the world, with its 32 turbine generators and two additional generators able to churn out a massive 22,500 megawatts of electricity. To put some perspective on this dam scale, because those numbers just whoosh, well, when it was first put into use, the workers had to use 200 tons of explosives just to level the temporary cofferdam structure that had been preventing the river from reaching the dam. Oh, and when the massive reservoir behind the dam was filled, it actually affected the Earth's rotation. Number 9. Offshore gas pipelines. To transport natural gas from Nyhamna, not sure if the pronunciation on that's correct, I did look it up, that's on Norway's west coast, to a receiving terminal in Easington, at the east of the United Kingdom. This monster of a delivery system is up to 44 inches in diameter, and the sheer massive size of its components required an upgrade to existing pipe-laying barges. The constructors also had to navigate some pretty insane obstacles. They had to construct at depths of 980 feet and perform difficult underwater weldings to existing systems. The welding process alone took roughly 6,000 man-hours. Still, despite its impressive size, the Langeland Line is not the world's largest offshore pipeline. That honor goes to the 760-mile Nord Stream pipeline and its upcoming parallel sister line, the Nord Stream 2, running from Russia to Germany. Nord Stream has received its share of criticism due to fears that Europe will become over-reliant on Russian gas, but regardless of your opinion about that particular subject, it's hard to deny the impressive engineering achievements of a project that size, as long as you're not stuck with the bill, that is, which is estimated at $9.76 billion, and that's just for the original Nord Stream, not the Nord Stream 2. Number 8. The Miu Viaduct. The Miu Viaduct is not only the world's tallest bridge, it's also one of the most impressive ones. At 1,125 feet, it is higher than the Eiffel Tower, and its length of 1.53 miles guarantees that the measurements match. What's more, the viaduct is designed to look like a huge, yet very slender yacht. It touches the Tam Valley below it in just 9 places. The Miu Viaduct was designed by Lord Norman Foster from the idea of French engineer Michel Virago, and it is specifically made to fit the impressive natural beauty of the area with the delicacy of a butterfly, as the architect put it. Although the bridge came with an understandably hefty price tag of $524 million, the building company that also constructed the Eiffel Tower happily financed the project in exchange for toll rights for 75 years. Number 7. FAST. China makes an appearance in this video again, this time with the 500-meter Aperture Spherical Telescope, or FAST, which is a solid contestant in the most contrived acronyms Olympics. It's also the biggest radio telescope in the world. The massive 1,650-foot-wide satellite dish and the accompanying research facilities cost $180 million and consists of 4,450 individual panels. To put this structure's massive size in perspective, it's roughly as big as 30 football fields. FAST was finished in 2016 and is currently at early research stages, but once it has been thoroughly tested and debugged, China has announced plans to open it up to researchers around the world. Because it's not only bigger and more powerful than all other telescopes, but also located in a very radio-quiet region, 1,240 miles southwest of Beijing, researchers anticipate that it has up to 10 times the potential to discover signals produced by distant alien civilizations, or even locate an alien homeworld. Apart from the the obligatory extraterrestrial hunting, the telescope will also become handy in a number of different ways, from detecting low-frequency gravitational waves to discovering brand new information about the universe and its beginnings. That is, if they can find enough people to operate the thing. In 2017, China was struggling to find qualified people to run the facility. Number 6. The MOSE Project. Venice is famous for its canals, architecture, hordes of tourists, and outrageous dinner prices. Unfortunately, these days it's even more famous for the fact that it's slowly sinking. The MOSE Project is the solution that the city is banking on to stop its seemingly inevitable march into the sea. MOSE stands for something in Italian I'm not going to try and pronounce, but in English it's the Experimental Electromechanical Module, and this consists of a complex system of retractable gates that are positioned in the harbor mouths that connect the Lagoon of Venice into the Adriatic Sea. When high floods threaten the city, closing the gate system will temporarily isolate the lagoon from the sea, leaving Venice safe from at least the most catastrophic floods. Unfortunately, ambitious projects, they tend to come with a lot of teething issues, and MOSE would probably be a few places higher on this list if it wasn't for the fact that it was originally supposed to be operational in 2011, later revised to 2014, but the project has been marred with difficulties and corruption. Its existing structures have been heavily damaged by mold, mussels, salt air, and technical issues, and the project's original price tag, an estimated $1.8 billion, has blown up to $6.18 billion. While MOSE is still in the works, the system is expected to be functional no earlier than 2022, and that's if everything goes well, and it probably won't. Number 5. Langkawi Skybridge. Sometimes small is beautiful. Though by no means a tiny structure, it is sort of dwarfed by some of the other items in this video. However, that doesn't mean it's any less of an engineering marvel. The pedestrian skybridge won the Swiss Steel Design Award in 2005 for its exceptional innovative design. The bridge is an impossibly flimsy-looking construction, 328 feet above the ground. And since said ground is atop the Machangchang Mountain, the views are nothing short of majestic. The curved free-span bridge, the longest of its kind at over 400 feet, is suspended from just a single pylon, and despite its seeming lightness, it can support up to 250 people at the same time. The structure abruptly closed down in 2012, which some took to mean that it was too rickety to use and would never open again. However, the bridge was actually just shut down due to a lack of maintenance funding, and after securing the money and making some improvements, it was open again for visitors in 2015. Number 4. Palm Jumeirah. Dubai is certainly noted for its ambitious construction projects, and possibly the biggest of them all is the Palm Jumeirah, which is the world's largest artificial island, and it also happens to be shaped like a palm tree. The tree island is more than just a decorative feature for passing planes and helicopters to gawk at from above, though. Its ornate shape adds a neat 50 miles of coastline to the city, and as such, the whole island is absolutely packed with luxury hotels, expensive villas, as well as mansions. The construction of the island started in 2001, and according to Business Insider, it took 3 billion cubic feet of sand straight from the Persian Gulf, lovingly sprayed into place using GPS satellites to make sure that the intended palm tree shape would be achieved. Unfortunately, such a massive undertaking has had a significant negative impact on the area's marine life and coastal erosion. Greenpeace has gone so far as calling the Palm Jumeirah a visual scar due to its construction process. Further, its presence has muddied once clear waters with silt, and it has buried entire coral reefs. Also, the island is sinking at a rate of about 0.2 inches per year, which is probably going to royally frustrate a few hotel owners somewhere down the line. But if all of that isn't ridiculous enough for you yet, don't worry, because as always, Dubai is prepared to go above and beyond. Palm Jumeirah is actually just the first of 3 super ornate artificial islands that they're planning on building. Number 3. The International Space Station. The International Space Station earns its place on this list simply by being the largest structure humanity has ever put into space. 15 nations have contributed to the construction, which was technically completed between 1998 and 2011. However, the station keeps evolving based on the needs of new experiments and missions. The ISS is 375 feet from end to end, which makes it roughly the same size as an American football field, end zones included. The station has been occupied since November 2, 2000, and by early 2018, no less than 230 people from 18 different countries have visited it. The ISS is constantly staffed by a 6-person crew of various nationalities who get to experience 16 sunrises and sunsets every single day. On the station, they live and work in a pressurized facility roughly the size of a 6-bedroom house, complete with 6 sleeping quarters, a massive 340-degree bay view, and a gym, which the occupants have to use for at least 2 hours every day to prevent muscle atrophy. The ISS may seem like it's far away, but a spaceship can actually reach it in just 6 hours after leaving the Earth. Thanks to the acre of solar panels affixed to it, you can even spot the station from land in certain conditions. NASA even has a website that helps you spot it. Number 2. Large Hadron Collider. The Large Hadron Collider, CERN's massive particle accelerator, was greeted with terror that you might remember, as several sensationalist media outlets thought that when it was switched on in 2008, the machine could create a black hole and destroy the entire world. As NASA rather sarcastically notes, the LHC completely failed to create the apocalypse. Instead, it has provided humanity with a whole host of stunning discoveries, and it's even earned several researchers a Nobel Prize when it proved their theory of the existence of the Higgs boson by, well, discovering the Higgs boson. From a purely physical standpoint, the LHC is a massive, magnificent structure that consists of a 16.78-mile ring made of superconducting magnets and accelerating structures that boost the energy of the particles. Inside the ring, two high-energy beams travel in opposite directions at nearly the speed of light in separate, isolated beam pipes that are kept in an ultra-high vacuum. The thousands of magnets that direct the beams along the structure have to be kept at minus 456.34 degrees Fahrenheit, which is colder than the temperature of outer space. Even with all of this hardware, the LHC's main function, making particles collide, obviously, is far from an easy task. CERN compares it to firing two needles 6.2 miles apart with so much accuracy that they managed to meet halfway. Pretty impressive stuff. Number 1. The Mars Exploration Rovers and Skycrane. After visiting the moon and building an actual space station, the next big thing on humanity's space exploration bucket list was Mars. In 2004, the twin rovers of Spirit and Opportunity landed on the red planet. The two rovers were only expected to be operational for 90 days, but both of them far outlasted their planned missions. Spirit explored the planet until 2009, when it became hopelessly embedded in soft soil. NASA was forced to abandon it after many months of futile attempts to save it. And Spirit's mission finally ended on May 25, 2011. Opportunity fared even better, and the solar-paneled rover was still tenaciously exploring away in the summer of 2018 when a bad planet-wide dust storm destroyed its systems. While the two rovers failed to find any conclusive evidence of current or past life on Mars, Spirit did discover that Mars had been a significantly wetter planet in the past, and Opportunity provided evidence that the planet may at one point have been suitable for sustaining microbial life. In 2012, the dream took a further step when a much larger craft called Curiosity landed on the planet's surface. Its delivery system was a feat of engineering all in itself because the rover was too large and heavy for standard airbags. Therefore, the engineers devised a fantastic technique known as the Skycrane. This method for soft landing is essentially a futuristic platform equipped with steerable engines, which enables it to act as a combination of parachutes and jetpack. When the crane neared the ground and slowed to a near zero velocity, the crane released the rover from its descent stage and gently lowered it to the ground with cables. This way, Curiosity arrived to its destination literally ready to roll. As a downside, the maneuver was extremely risky, and NASA less than lovingly dubbed the process 7 minutes of terror. Curiosity made the landing safely, and at the time of recording, is still exploring Mars. So I really hope you found that video interesting. If you did, please do give it a thumbs up below. And do not forget to subscribe. We've got brand new videos just like this every day of the week. Looking for more from me? Why not check out a new channel I'm doing called Highlight History? You will find that linked to below. And as always, thank you for watching.